Hello, this is Craig from bizfox.co.uk. This is the second video in our Blanchitsu series. So in this video, I'm going to be showing off the bags that we are sending off to our patrons, and I'm going to be using one of these bags, or a very similar one, to build a henchman for my warband. So we now have an extra patron on board, so I just want to shout out to Harry. So thank you so much for supporting our channel. We really appreciate everyone who jumps on board to Patreon. We have four patrons now in total on the $20 pledge, and they are all going to get one of these bags. So we have about seven in total, so there's still three more up for grabs. So the next three people who join on our $20 pledge will also be sent one of these bags in addition to their normal stuff. So these bags aren't as full as the big grab bag that you'd get for joining the $20 pledge. You will also get that as well if you join. So you'll get a bag this size full of bits, and then you'll get one of these as well, which have stuff to build henchmen. And we'll look at one of these in more detail in a minute. Now, they might not look like they've got much in them, but I really have gone for quality over quantity in these bags, and there's certainly a lot more than $20 worth of bits in these. So I've got one here as well, which I will be using. And we're going to crack it open, we'll go to the desk, and we'll start building a henchman. And then maybe I'll show you off one of my warbands as well. This henchman will be my second warband, but my first warband is now built, so I will show you that. Also, if you want to see close-ups of them and more pictures, if you go to blog.bitsbox.co.uk, I'm doing a little blog series to accompany these videos also. So just something to put on our blog, because we haven't used it much for quite a while, and I'll put a link down in the description below. So let's just get straight to the desk and we'll start building. Okay, so I hope the sound and camera angle's not too bad. Excuse the mess, and the desk is just, you can tell I use it to paint on. So let's crack open this bag and see what we've got. This has just been picked up at random from the back, so I think it's a little fun thing to do for my last little henchman. So we have quite a few bases in there, so we'll get them out. I'm only making one henchman out of this, but you should be able to make two or three easy out of these bags. And of course, if you combine them with bits you already have, you could certainly make most of your warband, I'm sure. And of course, if you sign up for our Patreon, you do get a big bag of other bits as well. So guys, I have plenty to convert with, so yes, it's a nice overwhelming pile of bits. I'm going to separate out the legs, and I'm sorry if this doesn't end up being riveting the video, I just want to try doing something different. But let us know in the comments if you do enjoy this video by the end of it. And there's some Skatari bits in here. There's all sorts. A lot of the boxes I showed you in the last video, there are bits from them. The GTO cults, hybrids, we have a lot of heads. Obviously some of the Empire stuff. So I'm not going to sit here and just separate everything, because that would just be boring. But another pair of legs there, so, you know. Legs alone are quite expensive on the site, and they're always quite popular, so as I said, it is quality over quantity with these bags, or at least I try to. So I'm going for like a wasteland sort of feel, you know, sort of the raiders from sort of Fallout. I'm going for that sort of feel. I've got this one here. This is a female one I did. Show to the camera. That sort of feeling. She's actually one of my favourite ones I've done so far. I don't know if I showed off in the previous video, but I quite like how she's come out, so I want someone to sort of accompany her. I'm just gonna, I don't know if it even that's on camera, but I've just stuck a lamp on just to make it easier to see. So out of the legs, I'm sort of torn actually looking at them. I've got a Scion's leg and some New Zealand cult legs. I know someone asked me the other day about doing a live video, something I definitely want to do in the future, and it would be quite cool to do something in the future where we can sort of build something together. But right now I've sort of got to make my own decisions. So We'll see what body we're going to use. I did pick up this one. This is like a Catchan one. Sort of like a bare-chested one. I think that'd be quite cool. That'd be something different. It might go on the Scion's legs a bit better if I cut it down. So we're going to go with that. Yep, I've decided. And we'll go on a... We better go on a 25. Yeah, I think 32 is just too big. I did put the other one I just showed you onto a 32, but that's only because our weapon was sort of overhanging and I didn't really like it that sort of overhanging that much. Just be good for consistency's sake. But then I've got another one in this, I've got another henchman, which is under 25, so. Decisions. I will go with the 25s. I think they come on the 25s, so. Obviously, the body and legs don't attach flush, so I need to chop that bit down there. You get to see the type of clippers we use here at Bitsbox. Never use the GW ones, they always break on me. When you cut up as much stuff as we do, they won't last 5 minutes, but these ones have been really trusty. I think I just got them off eBay. They have a good spring in the middle. The GW ones usually just have sort of bendy metal. And that always breaks. So, snip this off. So that's nice and flat. And then as you can see, that'll fit quite nicely on there. Obviously there's a bit of a gap. That's because it's not completely straight, so I do need to file it down. So again, riveting video, I apologise. I know this one won't be the most exciting thing, but it's more casual, something we can just sort of chill together doing. So, now I just need to file on the body as well. That's looking a lot better. So, clean-up's always important with miniatures. It's the most tedious bit. I hate doing it. I'm sure everyone else does. But when it comes to painting, you'll be thankful you did it. There is a bit of flash and mold lines on these Scion legs that just need tidying up. But they're pretty good, actually. Of course, for the bottom of the feet. So let's start gluing. I use, right now I'm using this Contactor Professional. Hopefully the needle's not clogged. Nope, it's all good. We'll stick him on there. And of course we'll stick the body on too. Sometimes I don't always stick the body on straight away because I like to sort of give them a bit of direction where they look, and sometimes you sort of need to get the arms done before you can decide that, but I think with this one we're going to be sort of more dead on. We'll just go slightly... Which one? Oh god, falling off there. We'll just put his body just slightly off to one side. So I'll let him dry, and we can look for a head. I mean, there's so many heads here actually, there's loads. So I'm certainly not spoiled for choice in this one. All these bags are completely different, although I have tried to sort of give them in sort of a roughly equal number of types of bits, so all of them should have 4 or 5 legs at least. I didn't realise how many heads there was, so you might end up with a lot of heads to choose from. But that's cool, because obviously variety is the spice of life. So I'm sort of going for like wasteland type of feel, so I don't really want anything too mechanical or anything that's just too bland either. That's quite a cool head. But there's a Gene Steel Cult one here I quite like. That's just bloody hard to see on camera, isn't it? It's got like a little sort of gas mask thing and goggles. I do quite like the Gene Steel Cult heads, they are very cool. What's this thing? That's a Scion's head. I think it's probably too big, but that's quite cool as well. I think we'll go with that. Now we have to go for weapons. So, all of the bags will contain these Gene Steel Occult shotguns and auto guns. They're quite popular. Also have some of the weapons from the Skitarii. You could actually just make a Skitarii range or two out of these quite easily. Some will have Tempest's Scion weapons as well, and this one doesn't. but some of them will. And I have a little Empire gun here as well. But I don't really want to use that, that's a bit too fantasy-like. I quite like this backpack, Jinsei Occult backpack. I think I might certainly put that on him. That's pretty cool. I'll give that a little clean-up. We'll put that to one side with the head. Okay, those are mace here, what's quite cool, but I really want more stuff that's more sort of not as fancy, I'd probably say, not clean, not that's wrong. I think I have both these sort of torch things here, I'll probably bung them in some of the boxes we give away. All the bits I don't use actually, I'll just chuck in the other bags. That we give away, because once this henchman's done, my other force is practically done as well. So I'll have two warbands by the end of this. So that's pretty. That's gonna be pretty cool. Then we can get into painting them. So I could just be boring and give him a shotgun. But I do quite like this. What have the other ones got? We've got a shotgun already, so. Yep, okay, I've decided I'm gonna go with this. Fire that up. So, a big thanks to everyone who's still watching. I hope this type of video, obviously it's something completely different. I don't know how well received or how badly received it will be. Personally, I'll probably be quite happy to watch some people convert up stuff every now and then. I know it's not the most exciting thing, but if you're painting new miniatures or building along, you know, it's something to have in the background, isn't it? So yeah, do let us know what you think, or if you have any other ideas for videos you'd like to see, we're always open for suggestions. We do have a bat rep coming up very soon. Which is the Yanari Elder, which uses my Exodites and the Visage, versus a Death Guard force. That's Wayne and Jab in that one. It is already up on Patreon, so if you want early access, you can watch that on Patreon. That's only $1 if you want the early access to the videos. You only have to sign up for the $1 pledge for that. But there are many other bonuses for sign up to the higher pledges, of course, including getting one of these. That's a really cool battle. We're up filming it quite late last night, as we tend to do with 40k, because the games just take ages. So let's see how this looks. Hope his arms don't look too weedy. The only thing is we've sort of got this bare chested body and we're sort of covering up a bit. But we might have to. Let's see what else we've got. We haven't really got any pistols or anything in this bag. I'm not going to go into any of the other ones. I realise why I use what we've got, so yeah, but I think we'll stick with that. Something like that's probably nah. Okay. We might have to just do a little bit of playing around with it, something like that. Yeah. He's got these big legs and big abs, but these scrawny little arms. But they're not too bad, it's hardly noticeable really. That HSR wall bander could be reasons for that. We don't have a lot of power fist here, it's pretty cool but too fancy for this type of guy. So let's get the arms glued on. I'll probably regret putting these on there when I want to put something on. Sort of hidden away, but I do want to add some pouches and stuff, and we should have some pouches and stuff in here. I see little bits about it. It'd be just my luck that some of the other bags have more pouches, but I see grenades and stuff. Okay, and that's already got glue. And just move over there. There's a bit of a gap. I'm hoping that's the actual right arms for it. See, these ones actually look a bit We might actually swap the arms now. Yeah, let's swap the arms. These ones don't look as scrawny. I don't like the autogun as much, but the arms do look better. That's if I've got another arm to go for it, mind you. And one thing I've found with making warbands is I do change my mind on stuff a lot. And that miniature I showed you earlier, she actually had a completely different left arm and different tabard on that originally. But I changed it. This must be the other arm. Okay. I think it is. If not, we'll make it the other arm. Let's file it out. Okay, he's sort of holding this up a bit. I think that's just the way it's forcing itself to go. Is this the right arm? Yeah, that actually fits quite well. Okay, so we have to just re-glue that. Come on! So anything about these nozzles, they do clog quite easily. His arm fell back into there, didn't it? There it is. Right, that's quite... I don't know, I'm not a massive fan of him holding the guns up like that. But that kind of works a bit, but not be too high. Let's not be too high. Let's hold up a bit, but not much. Probably have to green stuff a bit of a gap there. I think his shirt's sort of getting in the way. But now that's sort of working, and that gives us a bit of space just to get under and add some pouches and stuff. But I will probably just have to green stuff for that. And how would his head look? Head does look a little big, but I think it's just got this big sort of neck on it. I'll chop that down. Let's chop this little neck thing down. I think that's quite a flat space to go on. So, let's try and... Okay. Just cut around the sides. Hopefully this will still fit okay. Does look a bit it's a little bit crap actually. Need to file down more. So of course these old kits are a lot less compatible with the newer kits. Maybe that catch and body wasn't the best idea. Does sort of restrict where his head's going. I think a little bit of green stuff. That'll give us a neck. So, just file this bit back. Yeah, now file it down is actually a little bit better. But I will green stuff in. Yeah, I'm liking that. Okay. Let's get him glued in. Oh, the nozzle's getting clogged. There we go. Now, I'm sure most of you know how to unclog these needles, but if you don't, there are two ways that I like to do it. Yeah, I'm not a massive fan of that neck, but we will sort that out. Two ways I like to unclog these needles are you can either use a lighter, and that just sort of melts the glue inside, or you can get a thin guitar string and just poke through there. So, this is what we've got so far. I know the neck looks a bit naff, but we shall fix it with green stuff. Green stuff fix all. There's a little gap on his arm that needs fixing as well. But that's fine. I won't mind putting a little sort of shoulder pad or something on there if I've got the armour to do so. This thing's pretty cool. And I won't have all the claws and stuff, but I could chop some of that down. That'd work. That's pretty cool. And I'm going to do that. So we've got one of these like claw things here. I don't know if it's from a Rustalker or what. That could actually be from Belisarius call, because I did have a few extra bits from him. What's the point? I haven't actually added any Rust Stalker bits into these bags, so I might actually pop some Rust Stalker bits into the other bag so they'll have a little bit more than what you see here. Yeah, I don't like the claws on the front, but I quite like them on the back. So I'll chop off the claws. And pop that on there. It's like a very weird looking shoulder pad, but it's very cool. And what I want with these guys is that literally they make their armour up out of anything they can find lying around, so... He's got this little sort of Admech style shoulder pad. He's probably just got it off a dead Admech. And he's just bunged on his shoulder. That's pretty cool. Actually, before it dries, I will just neaten up this bit. So, put that back on. That seems to fit over his shoulder really well as well. I quite like the little claw sticking out of the back there. I do apologise if the camera doesn't focus at all. And I do apologise if it's getting boring now. I didn't realise we've been doing this for like 20 minutes now. But we are close to the end. I do like to load these up with a load of pouches and stuff, but we don't have to sit through all that. I don't actually have a load of pouches in this bag, unfortunately. Most of them do. But I wasn't too generous to myself with this one, I think. Lots of heads though, but we will take this little accessory thing, we'll take that. Oh, we do have our backpack as well, so that's actually, that'll negate our need for anything at the back. And it sort of fits in a weird way. Obviously I haven't got to be flush to the back really. We'll stick that on him, like so. That's straight. That's pretty cool, actually. So he's got his backpack. Oh, go this way. He's got his backpack on there. So. We do have lots of little cool accessories, mind you. Keep finding little bits now. Definitely gonna have these grenades. What side? That's a question. I think this side's gonna be better because there's arms raised. It's a shame that I've got a little pistol holder. Maybe I will take something out of just like spare bits I've got lying around. Yeah. Okay, so we're going to cheat slightly and just use one bit and something else. I probably will actually come back to them at some point and just put more on them. I like to just really load these henchmen up. Just stick loads of random armour, random pouches, grenades, holsters, all sorts on them, because as I said, they're gonna be like sort of wasteland sort of scavengers, so they'd pick up anything they can find. Just backpacks to go on a bit. But I think for this video, we will leave him there. As this video's got quite long, longer than I thought it would be, but this is the guy. I'll take some proper pictures of him once he's all dry, and I'll green stuff him, and then we can add him to the end of the video. But yeah, as easy as that. 20 minutes, we've just built ourselves a little henchman for the Inquisitorial Force, using the bits that we are giving away to our patrons. And if you don't plan to wish to sign up for our patrons, I have of course shown you in the previous video what sort of sets you can use, and most of them have been shown here in these bits, so you may just wish to buy a load of the bits or the sets that I've shown you previously, and hopefully this will give you some inspiration on how to use them as well. Okay, so if you have made it this far through the video, I do say thank you. So yeah, I completely lost my train of thought then. Just thank you so much if you have made it this way through. Well done, and I hope you have enjoyed this video. It's just something different. If you have enjoyed it, please let us know, because I can do more conversion videos like this in the future, no problem. But next up in the Blanchitsu series, I think we'll start some painting tutorials. I've got to do one for cloth, like a very sort of brown, muted, leathery cloth. So that will probably be the next one. Then I'm going to do some like golds and silvers as well. And then maybe bone, skin, things like that. Just get a really good sort of grimdark feel to the painting. So something different. And I hope you guys look forward to that. I'll see you all again in the next video.